I have one resident that barely opened her eyes. She didn't respond. As much as I tried, I knew her for 2 years. No matter what I tried, massage wouldn't work, nothing worked. But when we got introduced to the iPods and the family told me the things that she liked, it was amazing once we put the iPod on her. She started shaking her feet. She started moving her head. Her son was just amazed. Okay, can we stop? Because now I'm getting OR. I'm seeing her all over again.
Hi, Papa. Hi, Papa.
Huh?
How you doing?
I'm all right. I'm fine.
Who?
Wait.
Who am I?
I don't know. Wait a minute. I don't know.
Okay, it's Cherry. How long has he been in the nursing home? Approximately 10 years. He was having seizures, and my mother couldn't handle him at home. Of course it affected me greatly because he was always, you know, fun-loving, singing, you know, every occasion he would come out with a song, no matter where he was. I remember as a child, he used to walk us down the street, me and my brother, and he would stop and do Singing in the Rain. He would have us jumping and swinging around poles. He was, you know, he was good. He was always into music, you know, always loved singing, dancing.
His name is Henry Dreyer.
Uh-huh.
And I'm looking more or less for religious music for him.
Okay.
Because he enjoys music and he always quotes in the Bible. So I'd rather have that for him.
We first see Henry inert, maybe depressed, unresponsive, and almost unalive.
Henry.
Yeah.
Henry.
Yes, y'all.
I found your music. You want your music now? Let's try your music, okay? And then you tell me if it's too loud or not.
Then he is given an iPod containing, we know, his favorite music. And immediately he lights up. His face assumes expression, his eyes open wide. He starts to sing and to rock and to move his arms, and he's being animated by the music.
And he used to always sit on the unit with his head like this. He didn't really talk to much people. And then when I introduce the music to him, this is his reaction ever since.
The philosopher Kant once called music the quickening art, and Henry is being quickened, he's being brought to life.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the music for 1 second, okay? Just to ask you a few questions. Okay?
Thank you.
I'm going to give it back to you.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
The effect of this doesn't stop, because when the headphones are taken off, Henry, normally mute and virtually unable to answer the simplest yes or no questions, is quite voluble.
Henry?
Yeah?
Do you like the iPod? Do you like the music you're hearing?
Yes.
Tell me about your music.
Well, I don't have one, I mean.
Do you like music?
Yeah, I'm crazy about music. You play beautiful music, beautiful sound.
Did you play music when you were? Did you like music when you were young?
Yes. I went to big dances and things.
What was your favorite music when you were young?
Well, I guess, Cab Calloway was my number one band guy. I liked it.
What's your favorite Cab Calloway song?
Oh. I'll be home there for Christmas. Oh. You can count and plan on me with plenty of snow, mistletoe, present, red brand new tree. Ow!
So, in some sense, Henry is restored to himself. He is remembered. Who he is, and he's reacquired his identity for a while through the power of music.
What does music do to you?
Give me the feeling of love. No man, figure right now the world need to come into music, singing. You got beautiful music here. Beautiful, oh lovely. And I feel the band of love, dream. Lord came to me, made me holy. I'm a holy man. So he gave me this sound. I'll just say, I meet you. Let me see. Rosalie, won't you love me? Rosalie, won't you be sweet and kind?
With this beautiful new technology, you can have all the music which is significant for you in something as big as a matchbox or whatever. And I think this may be very, very important in helping to animate, organize, and bring a sense of identity back to people who are out of it otherwise. Music will bring them back into it, into their own personhood, their own memories, their own autobiographies.